Ministry of Culture, the Video Publishing Palace.
Există un loc.
There is a place
cu tainice
with mystical
porți,
recesses
în dangă
with
de
sweet and peaceful chimes.
Un loc ce păstrează
one place preserving rise and fall alike
și trudă în
and toilsome sweat in stone. The Cotroceni Palace.
De 300 de ani,
for 300 years, Cotroceni has been a name loaded with history. Although the church no longer exists today, the palace as a whole is structured on monastic traditions.
Tradițiile mănăstirești. Procesul de restaurare.
The restoration process began with the initial establishment, where each recess or archway represented by their uniqueness a triumph of Romanian architecture. These places witnessed the presence of such Wallachian voivods as Sherban Voivod, Constantin Brâncoveanu, the Mavrocordați, Alexandru Ipsilanti. Here stopped for a while Tudor Vladimirescu. This is where the heads of the 1848 revolution were imprisoned. The Cotroceni Summer Palace was inhabited by Alexandru Ioan Cuza, and it is still here that this prince was detained after his abdication.
Regele românilor,
the king of the Romanians, Charles I, bestowed the summer palace unto his heir, Prince Ferdinand, and to Princess Mary. Mary's children were raised here, Charles, Elizabeth, Mary, Elena, Mircea.
Maria, Elena, Mircea.
In 1923, the princess and future queen Mary summoned the famous French architect Paul Gautreau, together with the Romanian architect Grigore Cerchez, with a view to having neo-Romanian elements implanted here, according to her own wish. Mary valued the Cotroceni Palace no less than Charles did cherish the Palace Castle. The architectural background takes us back to the end of the 19th century. Renovation of the ceiling, furniture, and of the decorative objects is typical of the German neo-Renaissance atmosphere, completed by Bauer's paintings. In the hunting hall, the ornaments carved in lindenwood have been preserved and restored. The furniture is made up of pieces characteristic of the Italian Renaissance, namely cassapanca, seppia dantesca, scabelli. The throne hall, also known as the Golden Hall, is conceived in Cantacuzene royal architectural style, with floral elements and ornaments taken over from the walls onto the ceiling, to the doors and stained glass windows. The Louis XVI furniture, Vanier's paintings, and the ornamental pottery are the perfect image of the French eclecticism Gautreau resorted to. The Royal Library is one of the genuine pieces within the Summer Palace. The fireplace carved in Portoro marble has been restored. In 1925, a new architectural tendency imposed itself, leading back to Cantacuzene sources, according to the plans of Cerchez. The stained glass windows, recently restored, bear our voivode's heraldic marks. The dining room is provided with authentic pieces of furniture, the sculpture being represented by fantastic characters and archaic motifs. There are some elements taken over by the architect Cherkez, such as the stone portal reminding of the Kholtsa or the Horezo churches on portals, together with the unparalleled carvings of the monastery doors. The gallery exhibits an entire collection of several Limoges and Rosenthal porcelains, Venetian and Bohemian glass, as well as English and Italian pottery. One of the royal apartments was conceived in German style. The Biedermeier pieces of furniture as well as the decoration reduced to some inlaid vegetal patterns confer the space both sobriety and refinement. Queen Mary's Painting Hall is double in height in accordance with Gutterau's conception. The spiral stairs lead to a small Chinese hall. The painting hall used to be the favorite venue for cultural meetings, especially centered on painting, literature, and music. The royal dining room bears the very same marks of the German Renaissance sobriety. Thank you.
Dormitorul a fost
The bedroom has been renovated as well. The richly carved furniture, displaying both splendor and monumentality, depicts in a medallion the allegory of night. The Louis XV bedroom, carved in high relief, is obviously under the French influence. The accuracy of the parietal arrangements and the rhythm of the decorative elements make the pride of the style.
Și de ritmul elementelor decorative.
The Scandinavian mythology was recreated in the small Norwegian room dedicated to Queen Mary, to the memory of her cousin, Queen Maud of Norway.
The presence here at Cotroceni, as well as the Palace Castle, of the Art Nouveau style in furniture and in the ornamental pottery created by Don Moncey and D'Argental constitute an important and equally singular feature.
Gautreau envisaged this room, as well as the room next door, as belonging to the children. Their typical traits are given by the vaulted ceiling and the delicate decoration.
Images from the far-off Egypt and the antiquity coexist in the Empire-style hall as well as in the Adam-style bedroom. In putting up the third floor, rather reduced in height, Grigore Cerchez abided by his definite option for a Romanian expression of indoor space. Apparent here, and in several aspects, is the continuity with the old wing of the palace. The main hall intersects Cerchez's white hall with vaults and cross-cut technique. The columns resemble those of the Văcărești church porch. The impressive Union Hall is decorated with the armorial bearings of the three Romanian provinces. In the Corvins Hall, the Transylvanian Baroque harmoniously matches the vivid color of the stained glass windows. The Basarab's hall is adorned with decorative elements typical of voivodal houses. Stained glass windows are but an authentic gallery of the 14 princes, ranging among the founders of this country and of our nation. The Brâncoveanu style, with its typical sculptures, as they are to be found in this room, lines up with the resplendent white and golden explosion manifest in the Canta. Here at the Cotroceni Palace, apart from the wide range of styles and monumentality, a deep insight has been taken into the Romanian specificity so that following praiseworthy efforts, this museum is to be put back into the circuit of national values. A film by Laurențiu Damian and Anca Jurjuț. Consultants.